Good evening. Victoria is finally free of coronavirus for the first time since December. To celebrate the milestone, masks will no longer be needed in supermarkets. Workers can return to the office 5 days a week, and 75,000 fans will be allowed at the G for round two. Mark Santomartino begins our coverage.
For the first time since July, Victorians won't need a face mask to shop for groceries.
Right here, right? It's not much different to being in there, really.
If I'm told I don't have to, I won't do it.
Starting 6 p.m. this Friday, masks are no longer required inside any retailers, but you'll still need to carry one to wear on public transport, in rideshares, at the airport, inside hospitals, or to visit care facilities.
We're continuing to open up and return to the city and the state we love.
After 25 days of no local cases, Victoria's COVID-free once more. Active cases are at zero for the first time since December 11, paving the way for a full-scale return to work. The 75% limit on offices will also be removed on Friday night. Density limits still apply, but 100% of workers are allowed to return 5 days a week, with public servants urged to come back to city offices for at least 3 days.
We see that the 3 days is more of an aspiration and the starting point of a conversation that would need to happen with each employee.
That means up to 90,000 shifts, adding to the vibrancy of our city.
Employees who want to stay at home warned they'll have to compromise.
We're not as efficient at home. Our blue-collar workers have been doing this for months and months. So why shouldn't we all be getting back to the office?
1 year since Victorians were first told if you can stay home, you should stay home.
Painful, but it is absolutely appropriate.
Today's message couldn't be any more different, with visitor limits at home increased from 30 to 100 and up to 200 people allowed to gather in public.
If you can go out, you should go out, but stay COVID safe.
We're still seeing restrictions on hospitality. They need to be lifted because goodness knows there are too many people without a job in Victoria.
One person per 2 square metres is the only rule in place for restaurants, bars and cafes. A 75% limit up to 1,000 people still applies for indoor entertainment venues like galleries. However, caps on nightclubs, dance floors and karaoke bars have been removed. Same goes for the casino. All have been given 28 days to adopt a QR code system that connects with the government's contact tracing.
We want that data to be able to easily talk to each other, but this is about providing flexibility.
For events to fully recover, we need the remaining density limits removed.
Hard as it's been for the man imposing these restrictions.
Longest year ever.
Brett Sutton signed off on Victoria's new freedoms, confident the vaccine will stop the spread from hotel quarantine workers to the community.
That's kind of a ring of steel of its own for quarantine. This has been a hard-fought victory. I'm not sure Victorians recognise how grateful other jurisdictions are for what we went through in order to protect the whole of Australia.
Let's go live now to Mark outside hotel quarantine. Mark, travellers will soon be allowed to return home.
Expect an announcement before the end of the week, Pete. There are just 8 returned travellers currently in our hotel quarantine system. The rest are airline crew, and yet it continues to cost Victorians more than $1 million a day to run. That's despite international flights being paused last month at the beginning of the 5-day snap lockdown. We were told we were waiting on a review of the Holiday Inn outbreak, as well as the ventilation and the UK strain. Well, that review is now complete. James Molino, the acting premier, says the government needs a few days to go through the numbers, but then they'll be able to determine when those 10,000 Victorians stranded overseas will be able to start flying home and where they'll stay. Pete?